different than anything we've done before. My special guest this evening is William Cooper, and if you've been watching the show, you know that William has been with me twice before, and the response has been so overwhelming. Bill is here in New York because he's going to be lecturing, and he'll be telling you about that in a little while. So we decided to change the format of the show tonight. We decided to do it as a call-in show, so if you have specific questions that you would like to ask of Bill when we come back, please think of them and give us a call, and we will be more than happy to answer your questions. Okay, Bill?
Hello.
What have you been doing since we last interviewed?
Well, I've been working on the second volume of the two-volume set of Behold a Pale Horse.
Oh, maybe I should just show this. Last time we interviewed Bill, he was showing, he was first putting out his book, Behold a Pale Horse. Volume 2 follows it directly?
Well, when it's finished, I'm in the process of still writing it and compiling the information. Also, I've just completed a dream, really. I'm on radio now, have my own show. Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday nights from 9 to 10 p.m. Central Time on satellite. Anybody with a dish can download it. Any radio station with a dish can download it and
Anywhere in the world
and play it on their on their own airtime, and there's no charge to them whatsoever. And I'm doing this to try to educate the American people. It's on SpaceNet 2, Channel 7, 7.5 audio for those who have satellite dishes. And the first show will air on May 4th, Monday, May 4th.
That's just a week away.
Yes.
So is it a call-in show or?
It's not going to be a call-in show for a while. It's going to be an educational program.
Okay, now why did you come to New York this time?
Well, number one, you invited me.
Okay.
Number two, there's been a lot of people from the Northeast Coast who wanted me to come and talk. And I have an awful lot of research material that needs to be delivered to the people here. And that's what I'll be doing Sunday.
Sunday, Bill will be at the Universalist Church, Central Park West and West 76th Street, for those who want to come out to see him. I got involved with Bill's project about 3 months ago. And I thought, gee, maybe there'd be some response to him coming out. The response has been so overwhelming. I mean, I'm amazed. They love you. The material must be good and the information must be correct. Well, what we'd like the audience to do now, if they will, would be to call in if they have any questions, and we will be more than happy while we talk to answer your questions. Besides coming into New York, where else have you been lecturing?
Oh, gee, since we last talked, I've been in Seattle, Washington, Salt Lake City, Utah, Atlanta, Georgia. I've been in San Diego. I've been all over the country, actually, and we'll be in Orlando, Florida soon, Santa Fe, New Mexico.
Excuse me one second. May I help you?
Yes.
Yes, what is your question, please?
Well, I was just wondering what this information is that the gentleman will be delivering, because I haven't heard him mention the subject or the topic.
Oh, there's so many. Okay, go ahead.
It's a lot of subjects. It has to do with what's happening in the world today, what's been happening for the last 50 years, as a matter of fact. Over 20 years ago, when I was attached to the Office of Naval Intelligence, I saw top secret documents that told me a lot about what was going to happen in the future. I've made quite a few predictions over the last 5 years, all of which have come true exactly when I said that they would. I'm the only one in the United States, and even the world, as a matter of fact, who has a 100% accuracy rate on predicting future world events. I talk about the New World Order, what it really is, and not what Mr. Bush wants us to believe that it's going to be. About UFOs, about a lot of things, AIDS, the real reason for the Iraq war instead of the concocted reason that the public was told. It's an awful lot of information that's going to be delivered in a short period of time, and I would recommend that everybody bring a notebook and a good pencil and pen, because you're going to want to write a lot of things down.
Well, that sounds great. This is Sunday?
Sunday, yes.
This Sunday, 3 o'clock at the Universalist Church.
Where is the Universalist Church?
Central Park West and West 76th Street.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you for calling.
Thank you.
Hello, you're online.
Yes, I'm wanting to know what his short-term predictions for the future are.
Short-term, like what, next week?
How about the election coming up?
The election coming up, well, it's very simple. George Bush is really the man. He belongs to the world power structure. He's been an active CIA operative since he left college, and not just for the short period of time that the public thinks that he was the head of the CIA. And in my book, Behold a Pale Horse, I document the fact that he was an operative of the Central Intelligence Agency on the day that John F. Kennedy was assassinated, and that he was actually giving information to law enforcement officials to lead them down the wrong path, so to speak. But George Bush is dirty, and a lot of people know it. A lot of researchers have collected a lot of facts that could actually get the man impeached very quickly. His health is declining also. So the Bilderberg Group in last year in 91 picked Bill Clinton to be the next president of the United States. And that's what this whole thing is with H. Ross Perot. If he throws his hat in the ring along with Colonel Bo Greitz, then that's going to take a lot of the conservative vote away from George Bush and will literally ensure that Bill Clinton is elected as president of the United States. I'll tell you this right now, for everybody who's thrown their hat in the ring, it doesn't make a bit of difference who gets elected. None of them are on your side.
Then who really runs everything?
Well, it's not who anybody thinks it is. It's like Disraeli said, you know, a couple of centuries ago. The people that the public see as the leaders of their country are not the ones who are really leading at all. They're the puppets to take the attention of the public and the wrath of the public if need be.
Okay.
Are you saying that George Bush then is not going to be our president, next president?
If H. Ross Perot actually throws his hat in the ring and actually runs for president, George Bush will not be the next president, no.
I can't agree with that. I can't buy that. I'm sorry.
Just gotta wait and see, I guess.
Well, you'll have to see what happens to the conservative vote when H. Ross Perot throws his hat in the ring. He's going to capture most of the conservative vote. It'll split the Republican Party down the middle, and they won't have a chance against a united Democratic Party. All you've got to do to know that is just read the daily newspaper.
Okay.
I don't really rely on the newspapers for information. Do you?
Ma'am, when the elite of the world are talking, they talk through the New York Times. And when they're talking, you better listen.
We've got to move on to the next question, okay? Thank you.